Welcome. There we go. Thanks so much for coming to Shenda Music Camp 2021 here at Lancaster. We appreciate you showing up. Thank you so much for your attendance. Apologize if it's a few minutes late. We're trying to get the last few people in the door. We're actually trying to keep the last few people out of the door, actually. So, unfortunately, not everyone is going to get to enjoy this from the auditorium, but we apologize. It's only so big. So camp has been amazing. This last week has been an amazing experience for me, and I'm sure for all the campers that were here. We had about 230 couple of people registered, and it was a wonderful time. So a blessing to be here for us and for them, and I hope tonight is a blessing to you all. So if you came here tonight to be entertained, that can probably be accomplished. If you came here to hear great singing, that can hopefully be accomplished. If you came here to worship, and if you came here to honor and glorify God, that could be accomplished as well. So that's what our heart is, that's what our prayer is, that this can be a worship experience. If you think about it, when you bow your head to pray, generally you would close your eyes, right? And that is just to bring focus, and so that we can kind of tune out those distractions that we have around us, and to help us to kind of zero in on what it is we're doing. And I'm not going to ask you to close your eyes tonight during the program, obviously. I was thinking about making you turn all your chairs around the other way and just kind of face that way and just listen, right? But we're not going to do that, of course. But my point is this, that the heart of the singers and the choir and the directors is that you would enjoy the message more than the messengers. Does that make sense? That you would be able to worship with us and bring honor and glory to God through the message of the songs. A couple of little things. We're having some struggles with bandwidth as far as just signal out of here that this live stream. And if all of you could simply turn your phone off, that would accomplish two things. We would have no ringing in the service, which would be fantastic. And also, it would help us. We have signal, and as soon as this place is half full, we're just bouncing. So if you could all literally turn your phone off, not just silence it, we'll see if that can help us with that bandwidth issue we're having here with the live stream out. All right, you all have a program, so Daniel's going to come up in just a bit and lead us in a congregational song. And then we'll go through the program. In the middle, we'll have another congregational song, and we'll have a chance for you to share there with camp in the form of an offering at that point. And then we'll just carry on through the rest as is as in the program. A couple of things. Afterwards, if you could help us by simply, when you're done standing up, folding your chair and sitting it to the outside wall, that'd be great. Just stack them on the outside wall. And also, if you could somewhat keep moving as far as out of here. We're not chasing you out. We're not asking you to hurry, but just kind of head that direction. That would be helpful to everyone as far as getting things cleaned up and packed away. Daniel. Oh, he just said, I need to lead in prayer. Let's bow our heads for a word of prayer. Father God, thank you for your blessings today. We thank you for being here. Father, I just ask you to be with us tonight. Be with the choir as they sing. All the choirs, be especially the children. Just help them to focus. And Father, just ask that through our words and through our actions tonight, that we could bring honor and glory to you. Father, just ask that you would be with us all, every member of the choir and every member of the audience, that we could just use this as a time of worship and that we could be inspired and that we could go out of this place better equipped to serve you. Father, we just ask you would have all the honor and glory. In Jesus' name, amen.
In your programs, we will sing the one song, 261, Rise, Glorious Conqueror. Should be an insert in your programs, Rise, Glorious Conqueror.
Oh, rise, glorious conqueror, rise into thy native sky, assume thy right, and where in many a fold the clouds are back, we're rolled past through those gates. Reign in love. victor o'er death and hell, cherubic legions swell the radiant train. Praises all heaven inspire, each angel sweeps his lyre and claps his wings of fire, the Lamb once slain. Enter incarnate God, no feet but thine have trod the serpent down. Blow the full trumpets, blow wider yon portals, throw Savior triumph, and go and take thy crown. Lion of Judah, hail, and let thy name prevail from age to age. Lord of the rolling years, time for thine own the spheres, born
Came right back by and by. There arose a great storm of wind, and the waves beat into the ship, so that it was now full. He arose and rebuked the wind, and said to the sea, "Peace, be still." And the wind ceased, and there was a great calm.
is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, will we not fear, though the earth be removed, though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea, though the waters thereof roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake with the swelling thereof.
Holy One of Israel, in returning and rest you shall be saved. In quietness and in confidence shall be your strength.
Thank you. Good evening. Thank you for your part in this evening in attending. My name is Wendell Nisely, and I am the executive director of Shenandoah Christian Music Camp from Harrisonburg, Virginia. And I'd like to tell you a little bit about the camp and our vision, but I have to start with a thank you to Rod Martin and Marcy and their administrative team here. This is a mobile camp, and so as mobile camps do, they just kind of move from one community to another, but they put a lot of weight on locals to do a lot of the planning and to put things into place. And it is a huge amount of work. That's a fairly large camp. And they did a fantastic job. It has been a delight to work with them. I've decided Rod is a little bit like God. He just says, this is what's going to happen, and then boom, this happens. And it's amazing to watch that. So that has been wonderful. I think a lot of people are surprised to find out that music camp is more than this sort of event. This is part of what we do, but we do a lot of other things as well, and I'd like to tell you just a bit about that. Our vision is disciples whose music making reflects Jesus. And so we are wanting to help toward individuals and communities who are loving God, and that loving God happens also with integrity in the musical part of their lives. I was having an interesting conversation with one of the campers here and just saying, so how are the chapels for you? And the word he used was convicting. I was convicted, he said. Well, that was interesting, and so I asked him for a little clarification. He said, well, it's about his personal music, his personal listening habits. I said, so what are you going to do? And he said, well, I'm going to have to delete some songs from my playlist. I thought, wow, that's great. This is part of the look of discipleship. All of us have to delete some things from our lives if we're going to follow Jesus. So that was exciting to see. Our goal as a music camp is to provide resources and training in music and worship for the everyday Anabaptist. And so we hold events, the annual camp, there's Harrisonburg, Virginia, and one in Ohio, one in Ontario. Those are annual camps, and I told the first audience here, we sort of alternate. We have our camps, and then, you know, we have COVID, and then hopefully we have camps again. So we are hoping next year to have a camp again in Harrisonburg. We also create resources in music and worship, and just a few that I'll highlight. There are some brochures out on the table for Sing for Joy. It's an elementary music curriculum that is under development, but also in use right now. Also, a hymnal supplement, Into His Presence, is trying to bring in some particularly new music. We're delighted that there are a number of composers among us who are putting out wonderful music, and we're glad to be bringing that into the service of the church. There's also a curriculum in worship and rudiments for congregations and for older students, which we are using here. There's a congregation in the area who has also used it for their congregation. And one of the things that I'm particularly happy about with this curriculum is that it's one of the few places that I know of that round notes and shape notes are coexisting peacefully. So that is a particular happiness for us. We're also working at developing a children's songbook that is hoping to go to press this fall. And it's focusing on the life and the sayings, the teachings of Jesus. And that is called Follow Me. And you can find out a bit more about that on our website. We are a nonprofit organization, and we operate primarily by donations. And so the way this works is people give money and stuff happens. And so we invite you to be a part of that. If you wish, you can go to our website, musiccamp.info, and it can give online there. And of course, if you wish to interact with us about that, we are happy to do that with you as well. So again, thank you to you for coming. Thanks to the admin team and to a wonderful group of students. We just had one of the things my wife and I talked about here was the table conversation, the quality of that conversation. There's so much inquisitiveness happening there. students asking good questions, having great observations, and hungry to learn. And that has been a particular delight, and I want to say thank you to those students for that. Thank you. God bless you.
Good evening. At this time, we'll lift an offering. Take out of your programs the insert with Eternal Father, when to thee, and let's stand to sing. Eternal Father, when to thee. You may be seated.
Psalm 9:9, the Lord is a stronghold for the oppressed, a stronghold in times of trouble.
Psalm 73:26, my flesh and heart fail, but God is the strength of my heart and my portion forever.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
John 11:25 and 26. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And everyone who lives and believes in me shall never die.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
Revelation 7:10, salvation belongs to our God who sits on the throne and to the Lamb.
Revelation 7:12, blessing and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving and honor and power and might be to our God forever and ever.
Hambanati, 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 Kululiwe tu, Kululiwe tu, Kululiwe tu. To
give us peace in the journey. us peace.
Give us peace when the journey is done.
Give us peace.
Give us peace
when the journey is done.
The journey is done.
The journey is done.
The journey is done.
Hambanati,
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 Hambanati.
Hello, good evening. All right, in anticipation of the Mass Choir, I'm going to survey them. I didn't ask them about this ahead of time. All right, raise your hand, Mass Choir, if you're from the great state of Ohio. All right, what about the great state of Virginia? All right, let's go with the great state of Pennsylvania. All right, okay. Actually, it's a Commonwealth, but we'll go with state. And in honor of this lovely occasion with all of these Keystone Staters, I have chosen a Mass Choir song list where, for the best that I can tell, all of these melodies that we're singing were composed in the state of Pennsylvania. Not just by someone born here, but like they were living here and working here. So the first one, the tune is Nettleton. It's what we sing with Come Thou Fount of Every Blessing. We don't actually know for sure who wrote it. But we trace it back to a Harrisburg music publisher, John Wyeth, and that's the earliest that we can find this tune. So we're going to give him credit for it. The second song is one that I wrote when I was living in Meadville. And another after that is, what's after that? Stand By Me. This was a setting by Charles Albert Tindley, who was an African-American composer of the late 19th, early 20th century in Philadelphia. We'll follow that with another Philadelphia composer, William Kirkpatrick, who wrote the tune for He Hideth My Soul. And we'll close that with a recent tune written by Anthony Glick, originally from Lancaster County, currently a composer and school teacher living in Philadelphia.
Strength begins to Good evening.
The program says to hold the applause till the end. This is the end. So I would just like to say, from my perspective, it was beautiful. A job well done. So I just say thank you to each one for all the hard work. And just lifting our hearts to praise to God. Two announcements. Just to remind you what Rod said, when we're finished, please move, fold your chair and put it against the outside walls, please. Those who are parked on the other side of the 625, please form a line, or there'll be people out there to direct you. Go across at one spot. Single file kind of. Not necessarily single file, but at one spot. And only go when they tell you to go. I understand someone, you know, about got hit this afternoon. We don't want any of you to get hit tonight, okay? So try to work with that. Please stand, and we'll close with prayer. Let's pray. Dear God Almighty, our Creator, our Sustainer, you are so good. You are so merciful. As it was sung, the songs said it tonight. Father, we just thank you for your only begotten Son, our Savior. We just want to give honor and glory to you. Please bless each one who put all this effort into this program tonight and the much learning that was done this week. I pray that each congregation represented here would be blessed from it. We just thank you and praise you. We commit each one to you. We ask your blessing be upon us and that we be a blessing to others. In Jesus' name, amen. Depart in peace.